The party surprise. In the hills of Sodor, it was time for the narrow gauge controller's winter holiday party. The party was held at his house. All the children looked forward to it. Mr. Percival and his family lived near the engine depot, so all the narrow gauge engines could enjoy the party too. It was the day of the party. Freddy was working with Colin the crane. They were very good friends. Freddy was excited.
This party will be the biggest party ever.
Then Mr. Percival arrived. All this cargo must be loaded before the party.
Yes, sir, you can rely on us.
I must visit Mountain Village Station. I will be back in time for Freddy to take me to the party.
Yes, sir.
Freddy told Colin all about the party.
There'll be decorations, presents, and a big tree covered in lights.
Freddy was excited. Colin wasn't.
I've never been to a party.
Colin was fixed in one place. He couldn't move from the siding.
We never have parties at the wharf.
Then Freddy had an idea.
Maybe this year they could have the party at the wharf. It would be a surprise party for Colin, he thought cheerily.
Freddy had to find Mr. Percival. He wanted to ask him if they could have the party at the wharf.
I have to go and collect another flatbed.
And Freddy raced away. Freddy saw Mr. Percival bicycling away. Then he saw Peter Sam. He was pulling a flatbed full of presents and colored lights.
Those must be for the party, Freddy huffed to himself. I have to stop Peter Sam taking them to Mr. Percival's house.
So Freddy didn't chuff after Mr. Percival. He raced after Peter Sam instead.
Peter Sam, stop, stop! The party's now at the wharf.
Peter Sam was surprised.
It will be a surprise party for Colin. I'll take your flatbed. Will you tell the other engines?
All right, Freddy.
And Peter Sam raced away. Freddy shunted the flatbed to Colin.
Leave this flatbed until I come back.
Colin was puzzled, but he still had lots to do, so he carried on working.
Now I must find Mr. Percival, Freddy thought.
And he raced away. On his way, Freddy met Rusty. There was something long and pointy on his flatbed.
It's the tree for the party.
The party's now at the wharf.
Rusty was surprised.
I'll take your tree. Will you tell the other engines?
All right, Freddy.
And Rusty raced quickly away. Freddy puffed and huffed to Colin.
Leave this flatbed until I come back.
Colin was puzzled. But Colin still had lots of other work to do. So Freddy raced away. It was getting late, and Freddy still had not asked Mr. Percival if they could have the party at the wharf. At last, Freddy puffed up to Mountain Village Station. But Mr. Percival wasn't there.
Mr. Percival's already gone back to the wharf.
Oh, no. I must puff back as quickly as I can.
At the wharf, the two flatbeds were still waiting to be unloaded. Mr. Percival was cross.
Please, unload these at once.
Freddy had told Colin to wait for him. But Colin didn't want Freddy to get into trouble.
Yes, sir.
Then Mr. Percival went to look for Freddy. Soon, Freddy puffed up to Colin.
I waited for you, but Mr. Percival told me to finish the job. It's all done now.
He was very pleased. Freddy looked down at the canal. He wasn't pleased at all. The lights, presents, and the tree were floating away on a barge. The children would soon arrive at Mr. Percival's house, and there was nothing there for the party. And there was nothing at the wharf either.
Now no one will have a party, Freddy huffed to himself. And I still haven't found Mr. Percival.
He felt terrible.
I must stop the barge.
Then Freddy saw Mr. Percival. He knew what he had to do. Freddy chuffed over to see Mr. Percival.
Where have you been?
Freddy told him all about his idea to have the party at the wharf.
It was a surprise for Colin, sir. Colin has never been to a party.
Mr. Percival thought having the party at the wharf was a very good idea. But you should have asked me first.
Ah, yes, sir.
If I work quickly, I can still put everything right.
All right, Freddy, but hurry now.
Freddy raced to catch up with the barge. He called out to the bargeman.
Stop! Please turn around and go back to Colin. All right, Freddy.
Freddy steamed back to Colin. He told Colin all about the party.
I wanted to have a surprise party for you.
For me?
Colin was delighted and surprised. Soon, Colin was unloading everything for the party. Now, Freddy felt very happy. He steamed away to Mr. Percival's house. Freddy whistled to the children.
The party is now at the wharf.
And they whooshed away. All the other engines were waiting at the wharf, even Thomas. Presents were piled high. The tree was covered in lights. And so was Colin.
What a wonderful party! Thank you, Freddy!
Freddy was delighted. All the engines whistled and tooted. The children cheered and cheered. It was their best winter holiday party ever.